A hearty good afternoon to all present. Today, I, Ishwar Mittal, would be going to explain you the experiment Bernoulli's theorem. We all have read about Bernoulli's theorem, which states that the flow, the total energy of a fluid remains constant, or we can further elaborate it by saying that in the horizontal flow of a fluid, the point with higher speed will have less pressure as compared to the point with less speed. Now, talking about the main objective of this experiment, it is to verify and prove the Bernoulli's theorem. Now we will be going to talk about the Bernoulli's equation. The Bernoulli's equation is an approximate relationship between pressure, velocity, elevation, and is valid in the region of steady incompressible flow where the net frictional force or frictional losses are less, as we don't take them in account while proving the Bernoulli's equation. Now you can look at the equation as well. The total head equals to pressure head plus velocity head plus elevation head, where pressure head equals to P by rho G, where P stands for pressure at that point, rho stands for density of the liquid, and G stands for acceleration due to gravity. Velocity head, which is equal to V square by 2G, where V stands for velocity of the liquid at that point and G stands for acceleration due to gravity. And elevation head, Z, which is the height. Now we will be going to talk about the apparatus required. The first is supply tank. From this, the water is supplied to the Venturi meter. Now, tapered inclined pipes, piezometer tube at different points. And these are connected to Venturi meter at different points with different cross-sectional area. These are used to measure the total head at different points. Venturi meter. It is actually a long head. Venturi meter. It is broader at the end and gets narrower in the middle. Scale. It is used for measurements. Measuring tank. It is used to collect water. Stopwatch. It is used to collect a note down the time taken for rising 10 cm of height. Now further, Gayatri would explain the experiment.
Good afternoon, everyone. Today I will be talking about the overview of this experiment. So what we're gonna do is we'll use the supply tank to get the water flowing into the tapered inclined pipe, and as the water flows through it, the piezometer tubes will record different pressure heads, because pressure is different at various points because of the different cross-sectional areas, and then we'll note those readings down and also calculate the volume of the tank as to calculate the discharge, and we'll make necessary calculations and verify Bernoulli's theorem. Now with the help of a video, we'll show you how the experiment is carried out. So this is the storage tank. This is the tapered inclined pipe, which looks like Venturi meter. It has different cross-sectional areas, and these pipes are piezometric tubes, which will use to note the pressure head. Now, the water which we'll use, we'll have to use the pump so that the storage tank is filled with water. We'll switch on the motor so that storage tank fills completely, and will keep the valve closed till then. And now the further experiment will be explained to you by Gitika.
We will close this valve closed till our tank fills completely with water. Now our tank is filled, so we are going to close the motor. This tank is filled completely with water. Now we'll open this valve so that the water can flow through this tube and we can get different readings in piezometric tubes. As we can see, when we have opened the valve, water started flowing and we get the different values of the height in different piezometric tubes. We can see the region where area is less, height of the water collected is less. And as the area of the pipe per tube increases, the height of the water collected in pipe is also increasing. And as the area of the tube decreases, height of the water is decreasing. With the help of these heights, we can calculate our pressure head, velocity head, and potential head. So this was a simple experiment to verify Bernoulli's theorem by using pressure head, elevation head, and velocity head. These are some formulas which will be used in calculation. The volume of the water that is collected in tank can be calculated by multiplying area of the tank with the height of water that we have collected in T interval. Length and width of tank is 250 mm and the height that we have collected in T second is 10 cm. Discharge can be calculated by dividing volume with time interval which has been taken for 10 cm rise of water. Velocity of the flow can be calculated by dividing discharge with the area of piezometric tubes. This will be different for different piezometric tubes as they have different areas. From all these, we can calculate total head, which is the sum of pressure head, which can be calculated by dividing pressure energy with weight, velocity head, which can be calculated by dividing kinetic energy with weight, and potential head, which is calculated by dividing potential energy with weight. Now further, these calculations are explained by Gopal.
Hello everyone. With the help of above calculation by using different formulas of velocity head, pressure head and elevation head, we can make this table. In this table, different calculated values of the velocity head, pressure head, total head, elevation head is taken. If we look at the values, we can conclude that when the pressure head decreases with the distance, velocity head increases, and the pressure head increases, the velocity head decreases. And we can draw graph between the pressure head and the distance. Also, we can draw the graph by using this table, graph between the velocity head and the distance and total head and the distance. And by using this table, we can confirm the Bernoulli's theorem and we can conclude that this table and graph found by this table follow the Bernoulli's theorem. And next table is for the 75% flow rate. In this table also graph will same and the conclusion will be same. When the pressure head decreases, the velocity head increases, and pressure head increases, the velocity head will decreases. Both the table, by concluding both the table, follow the theorem of the Bernoulli's. Next is observation. The pressure head or the piezometer reading is equal P by W. Area of cross section of tapered pipe under piezometer tube is following A1, A2, A3, etc. Area of measuring tank is 250 mm square. Height of water collected for T interval of time is 10 cm and the elevation head is Z. Further, Arch will describe the graph made by this table.
Now I will discuss about the proceedings of the graphs. In graph 1, as we move along the Venturi meter, cross-sectional area decreases in the converging cone and becomes minimum at throat and again starts increasing in diverging cone. So velocity increases and pressure decreases as we move from converging cone towards throat and vice versa from throat to diverging cone. In graph 2, velocity head is given by V square by 2G. That is, velocity head is directly proportional to velocity square. As velocity is inversely proportional to cross-sectional area, so it increases from converging cone towards throat and decreases after that. So does the velocity head. In graph 3, according to Bernoulli's experiment, total head is meant to be constant at different sections. But the graph shows that it is decreasing because of loss in energy due to frictional losses. Moving to results, hence Bernoulli's theorem is proved, that is, pressure head plus velocity head plus elevation head of one section is equal to pressure head plus velocity head plus elevation head of other section. Now moving to precautions, avoid parallax effect and note readings carefully. Avoid overflowing and stop the timer at accurate rise. This was all about the presentation today. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.